Hi everyone! Today I'll share some tips and ideas on making Redbubble stickers of your art using Photoshop. This might be a bit of a longer video, so I'll put timestamps below so you can easily get to the part you're interested in. I'm using Photoshop CC 2020 for the editing. If you don't have Photoshop, you can start a free 7-day trial. Adobe also has student discounts and different offers if you want to buy Photoshop. I'll link those below in the description and on the video. And full disclaimer, they are affiliate links. So I'm making sticker designs for print-on-demand shops like Redbubble using my traditional art that I've previously scanned. I've also edited the contrast, sharpness, saturation and so on, which you can see in my previous video about editing your art with Photoshop. I also talked a bit about the RGB and CMYK color modes in that video. I'll show you 5 examples of how to make sticker designs of your art. If you just upload your art as is with a background, you'll get a rectangular or square sticker, which isn't the most interesting shape for a sticker. And I have a bunch of stickers like that in my shop, so let's go ahead and edit some of those. If you have an artwork with a solid color background, like this beetle drawing, the easiest way to remove it is with the magic wand tool. So click on the select tool, then right click it to open the menu where you can choose the type of selection tool. You can set the tolerance for the magic wand tool if the object you're cutting out has similar colors to the background. Like here, I'm cutting out this beetle pencil drawing from the white background, but the beetle has some light areas as well. That's why I'll set the tolerance low, so it will only select the harsh white. If the image has multiple areas where the background is showing behind the object that you need to cut out, choose the Add to Selection mode. And then go ahead and add a transparent layer underneath the artwork by right-clicking the layer in the Layers tab and choosing Duplicate Layer. Then set the bottom layer invisible by clicking the eye icon next to it. This will give you a transparent bottom layer. Now select the top layer and press Ctrl X to delete the background, and you should be left with a transparent background and the object visible. You can always undo with Ctrl Z. I like to check that I've gotten the background fully removed and there aren't any leftover pixels by adding a contrasting solid color layer underneath. I had a white background in this one, so I'll use a black one now so that it's easy to see the white pixels on it. Add a new layer on top of the bottom layer with the plus sign and choose a contrasting color. Go to Edit, Fill, Fill with background or foreground color to add a solid color background to it, and zoom in so you can see that there aren't any rogue pixels left, and if there are, just use the eraser tool to get rid of them. Make sure you've selected the right layer before erasing though. Then hide the solid color layer with the eye icon and save the image at File, Save As in PNG format, which preserves the transparent background. And you're ready to upload it to Redbubble. For something with a non-solid color background, like this watercolor painting, I would use the Quick Selection tool. So click on the selection tool and right click it, and then you can choose the quick selection tool. Check the enhance edge option if there's no check mark. You can also make the size of the brush smaller to make the selection more precise. Just paint with the mouse to make the selection, and you can add or remove from the selection by pressing Alt to change the mode or change it from the top bar. You can use this method to cut out any character from your painting for a sticker. If the character cuts off in a straight line, you can round out the edges of the sticker. I showed you how to do that with GIMP in a previous sticker video, but I'll show you how to use the elliptical marquee tool later in this video to make a circle cutout with Photoshop too. And that can also be used for rounding out some of the corners. When you're done, let's add a transparent background again by duplicating the layer in the Layers tab, hide the layer with the eye icon, and then press Ctrl X to delete the background of the top layer. To check for any rogue pixels, add a solid color background and remove any extra pixels with the eraser tool. You can also move the object to center it inside the canvas. I also fixed the sharpness and used the healing brush tool for some quick fixes on this one. You would want to do these things to the actual image with the background though, not just the sticker with the transparent background. I just didn't catch these mistakes till now. I'm saving the image as PNG and then I'll go ahead and edit this listing on Redbubble at Manage Portfolio. Click the settings icon and edit. Find the sticker and again click edit and then replace the image. Find the right one and let it upload. I added this same file on a bunch of the other products as well. And then save and let it process. Here's the final result for the sticker and here's what it looks like before and after. You can also leave in part of the background. So with this Arctic Animals painting, I leave in the gold diamond shape in the background, but cut out the northern lights and black background. So the antlers of the reindeer and the feet and tails of the other animals are spilling outside of the gold diamond background, but I'll keep them in the sticker. I'll use the polygonal selection tool to get straight lines for the diamond. Click on the lasso tool and right-click it to select the polygonal tool and click each corner. Now the antlers and stuff are left outside of the selection, but I'll add them by changing the selection mode to add to selection and using the quick selection tool. If you select too much, hold Alt while selecting parts to remove them from the selection. As with the previous designs, add a transparent background by duplicating the image layer. Hide the bottom layer with the eye icon and invert the selection at Select Inverse because we've selected what we want to keep, not what we want to delete. Then press Ctrl X to delete the background of the top layer. To check for any rogue pixels, add a solid color background and remove any extra pixels with the eraser tool and the polygonal selection tool. I added both a black and a white background and switched between them to make sure I got clean edges. Save the image as PNG to upload to Redbubble. You can use shapes like circles and diamonds and triangles for the background and include areas like ears of an animal character or other small parts that spill outside of the shape. And here's the rectangular version and the new sticker design for comparison. How about if the artwork is a landscape or something without a character or an object? Even just a circle might be a more interesting sticker design than a rectangle. I'll show you how to do that with this sunset painting. Take the rectangular marquee tool, right-click it and choose the elliptical marquee tool from the menu. Set style to fixed ratio of 1 to 1. Make sure that View Snap is selected. Now draw the circle and you can move it where you want to. It should snap to the edges of the canvas. Again, add the transparent layer by duplicating the image and setting the bottom layer invisible. inverting the selection and removing the background with Ctrl X. I'll add a slightly bigger square background for this to make sure that if I use it in a repeating pattern on Redbubble, it's going to have even spacing. So go to File, New and set the Width, Height and Resolution. Drag the circle over to this new blank image. And save the PNG and upload to Redbubble. The next idea is to add an image inside a silhouette. I'll add a sunset landscape inside this elephant head shape. Open both images in Photoshop, then drag the image or shape with a transparent background over to the landscape image. You can resize by dragging the edges or corners. The aspect ratio should be preserved, but if it's not, hold Shift while doing it. You can lower the opacity of the top layer to better see where to place it. To make a transparent layer underneath, duplicate the bottom layer and set it invisible. Select the top layer and use the magic wand tool to select the transparent background. Then select the middle layer and press Ctrl X to remove the background. Next, set the top layer invisible from the eye icon and you should have an image inside an image. Crop the image so you're not left with too much blank space around the cutout and save as PNG to keep the transparent background. You can also make sticker sets for Redbubble, meaning multiple stickers in one listing. So I'll demonstrate with these three paintings. I've already removed the background, but to use this as a sticker set for Redbubble, I need to make sure that the trees are spaced out enough so that they'll be cut out individually when they're printed. So I made a new file with a transparent background with a bit bigger dimensions compared to the original image. I'll drag the trees over to this new blank image and then I'll use the rectangular select tool to select the individual trees, cut them out with Ctrl X and paste back with Ctrl V to make a new layer for each tree, and that way I can move them freely to make sure there's enough space between each one. And of course save as PNG to upload to Redbubble. For more image editing and print-on-demand tips, click on the videos on the screen. And stay tuned for more Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching! Bye!